Okay, those are three options out of four. These four options, because the last one is when the opponent immediately counterattacks, because he's been reading the early German longsword sources closely and knows that it's good to strike back, which is right. But these are the most common things that I see how people react. I mean, usually it might be a combination of both. A good fencer might parry a counterattack, or you know, he might step back because he wants to do an uprising. But as a general rule, these are the four ones. He does nothing, you commit. He goes to parry, you strike around, maybe you can find another solution. He retreats, you pursue. And if he counterattacks, you can either evade his counterattack with, like, say, a Zufechten, which looks like this, and strike in, you just make a quick counterattack. Okay, that's what he likes to do. Good, next time. Evade and counter. Or if he comes in a little bit more committed, then you need to abort your attack, take the center line, and just basically go with a parry almost. And then you can continue on with the wine. So this time, you come a little bit closer with your attack. And I know what he will do this time. In theory, at least. So, the fourth option then. You make your preparation, your information gathering, he responds with a counterattack. You quickly bounce out of that one. If he does it short, the next time you evade underneath as the first one. If he does it committed when you come in, you parry instead, and then you can start using counter. If it's a wine or if it's something else, that doesn't really matter. But you abort the attack into a strong bind, and then continue. So that's number four. Now you coach, you know you have four options. Do nothing, parry, retreat, or counterattack. And your friends will have to respond properly to those four. Okay, that's the last one. Let's try that out.